Greetings, Simplicity. Today, our guest author needs absolutely no introduction. He is the Commissioner of Coimbatore, Dr. K. VijayaKarthikeyan. But today, we are not asking him questions on the city development, but on his book, Once Upon an IAS Exam, a book written on a more hilarious side. But to get more details, let us find out from him. Thank you, sir. Thank you so much for joining on our show. So you have studied MBBS and then you wrote your civils and an IAS officer, now a commissioner for the Coimbatore city, and a book. Which of it do you enjoy the most and why?
As such, I enjoy all the roles that you've described, and all of them are very close to me, and the kind of stress levels in the other things that you just told are very high. Primarily, the reason being you get to connect with people with all walks of life, help them out with their problems and so on. So that way it is very soul satisfying being an IAS officer,
working as a commissioner and helping out people. But then writing book is something that I personally enjoy as a person, to spend time, my own personal time, on something that I really like doing. So that way, that is very close to my heart.
And every job that you've taken as a writer, as an IAS, and now as the commissioner also, how do you balance, because all of them are time consuming, so how do you balance?
This current assignment as such is again very hectic. Generally, the life of an IAS officer is a very hectic one, but then I make it a point every day to allot at least an hour or so for myself. So this sort of a write-up every day for an hour or so helps me unwind, helps me de-stress, and helps me rejuvenate myself.
When we talk about your book writing, this is your fourth book. The previous three were written in Tamil and they were non-fiction. And this is your first attempt to an English book, which is a fiction. And the language, from what we read, is very, very colloquial. How would you like to describe your style of writing and keeping it very simple? Yeah.
That's my mantra generally, to keep things as simple as possible, as elementary as possible. And by a book, we should be able to reach as many people as possible. So that is why I'm very particular in keeping the language of the books in a very simple tone. Everybody can easily understand and everybody can connect to the book.
From the first book to your fourth book, there has always been a progression when a writer goes step higher. So what is the kind of development you see in yourself as a writer?
Yeah, during the journey through these books, I've tried to further simplify things. A, make it very simple, as simple as possible. B, make it as light and as humorous as possible. So that is what I've tried to bring through in this book.
IAS is supposed to be a very serious subject in itself, but over the reading of the book, there are a lot of hilarious moments that are there, and there's a twist of a romance tale in the book also. So how would you like to comment on that?
As such, it's a very serious exam that we write, but then a lot of such interesting scenarios do come up in the due course of preparation. In my case as well, during my course of preparation, I have seen a lot of such people around me and a lot of interesting tales turning up around me. So this book, I thought, would be an amalgamation of whatever I had seen and whatever I had felt as an aspirant writing this exam. So I thought I'll bring that out in an interesting tone, and in a tone that could reach to everybody.
The book and the experiences the main character Vishi goes through, how relevant is it to your personal life or to your story?
No, this is not my story, first point, a disclaimer. But then when you write such an exam, when you sit and put your heart and soul into it for say 1 year, 2 years time, you see a lot of people around you, a lot of interesting things happening around you. So such interesting things and such things that happen around me do find a place in the book.
When we read about authors, we generally see that there is a pattern of genre that is followed. But when we come to your books, there are different exploring genres to look into, motivational, educational, and now we have a comic come love story with the background of an IAS. What is your future project about?
And I'm a generalist as such, being an IAS officer, I get to switch departments and go through a lot of different fields. And being a doctor originally, I'm used to switching across things. Same habit has come through to my books as well. Initially started with the educational book and then motivational books, and now to fiction. Future also, I've written a thriller, and that's under again progress. And also planning to write a few more self-improvement books. So I don't intend to stick to one genre or one sort of writing. I would again like to explore all possible genres available and all streams within my limits.
And just to sum it all, if you could give us a brief synopsis of the book so that it immediately urges the audience to see this side of you.
Yeah, it is about a 25-year-old boy named Vishy who has just failed in the UPSC civil services exam. The primary character, as such, Vishy, is again in a confused world. A state of insecurity would happen to anybody. So what happens next? What does he do? He has a love life as well, waiting to happen. Does that really happen? And how does he pick up the broken pieces and make them together? And how does he climb the mountain of clearing the IAS exam? Will he answer all these questions? And how he goes about all of these things, and the kind of the disappointments, the challenges, the obstacles, the happiness, the sorrows and joys that he faces over the course of time with regards to all these things forms the core plot of the story. By the end of the book, I'm sure all of us can connect to Vishy, and all of us would see some element of us in the lead characters of the book, and never give up on reading. Reading habit has taken me to where I am today. So reading is so important to us, and it could teach us a lot of things, and it could make us better people. So I really would urge the youngsters and the next generation to take up reading, and again share and spread the word and inculcate reading as much as possible.
Would you like to dedicate the book to anyone in particular?
No, I'll dedicate this book to again all those the lakhs and lakhs of aspirants who are struggling out there, trying to make that decision between their career and their love life. And this book is for everybody who would have been in that situation or sitting in that situation. So this book, Once Upon an IAS Exam, is releasing in the first week of October. It will be available in the all leading outlets, also available online in Amazon.in, ThinkInc.in, in Flipkart and other leading online websites. Published by Rupa Publications, it would again be available at all leading stores.
Thank you, sir. Thank you so much for these inspiring ideas and thoughts, and we wish you all the best for your book, and may you continue writing some more books that inspire the youngsters.
Thank you so much. Thank you very much.